Hey, welcome to my first ever video. I'm going to be playing a little bit of Football Manager in this first one. I was going to play something like Call of Duty or whatever, but I wanted to go with something that I know that I'm pretty good at, that I've, you know, had success with in the past, and just get that out there. See if anybody likes it, and hopefully you will. So I'm starting off here. If you're new to Football Manager, first of all, this is where you get to choose your managerial style. Now, I'm going to be managing Newcastle in this one. And the reason I'm going to be managing Newcastle is because, obviously, they've just been relegated. I just kind of like the challenge. I like the idea of trying to take them back up to the Premier League, make them a force to be reckoned with in the Premier League as well. They're sort of a sleeping giant, you know? And I want to get them back up to to those high standards that, you know, they were once at. obviously, they've got some huge legends in football when it comes to, you know, just footballing royalty, realistically. I mean, you've got Alan Shearer just to start with. But yeah, that's what we're going to do. So to get on with it, what I normally do is I always just make sure I'm maxed out on these. It depends on whether or not I'm trying to do a challenge. If I'm trying to do something that is a little bit more challenging, I might start off with like Sunday League experience on both of these. And the reason, or, you know, like a National C license, the reason for that is obviously it makes it harder for you to get jobs. But the realistically, I'm hoping not to get sacked. If I do get sacked, then that's going to suck. We'll probably move on to a different club. But we're going to start off managing the Magpies. So let's see what we can do here. So generally, I don't worry about this stuff too much. Main reason being, I like to try and bring in coaches that do this stuff. I don't feel that, you know, my time's best spent here. I find this a better area to be focusing in. Adaptability, determination, player knowledge, all this stuff, it comes in handy when it comes to like actual management, I think. So that's how we're going to start off. We're going to confirm this and start. So that's fine. And we'll just name it Managing Magpies. Okay. So to start off, all we're going to do realistically is we're going to set up the team. We're going to set up what we think, what formation I'd like to play, and how we're going to kind of approach this season. And then we're going to look at where we might try and make transfers. And then I'll probably come back to you at the start of the season. This, by the way, is my game face. For some reason, the colour is like way off. It came off basically as like blue, so I had to adjust it. But like the colouring is really off. I mean, I can see some similarities there, I suppose. It's a little bit of an odd one, though. But that's my game face for Football Manager 2017. It also seems to be a little bit skinnier than I am, to be fucking honest with you. Right, so let's see. So obviously we've got, you know, Newcastle, hire Harris. We've got my wage. They're going to ask us to come to a meeting. So we're going to go to this meeting. I'd like to take a few minutes of your time welcoming you to the club before handing over to your assistant manager, who is going to discuss staff responsibilities with you. I also want to assure you that you're full back on the board. Okay, let's get it started. I'm already familiar with the club. If you do want to read these, feel free to pause in and have a look. I have played Football Manager enough and done enough saves that I kind of know what we're going through here. Okay, that's fine. Nope. Yeah, that's great. That was my phone, I apologise. Using the rest of your staff. Okay, so I always have the staff. Oh, I don't get to, do I not get to choose the frequency anymore? Normally you can, is it in here maybe? I'll have a look now, agent offers. So with friendlies, can you arrange to take offers? So friendlies I generally just don't take care of because I don't care about them. Realistically, I just think we're better off having it all managed by the assistant, which in this case is Miguel Antia. I also like to get my assistants to set up the opposition instructions, just because, again, I don't think, I like to play the game fairly quickly. I don't want to go into too much detail. This stuff I like to stick with. That's normally already taken for. I'm pretty happy with the situation at the moment. team talks, training, that's fine. I'll leave that where it is. Okay, so start off, we'll go, hold on, I'll exit that too. Okay, start off, let's have a look. Transfers update, so we've got Tauvin going to Marseille for 11 million. We've got Atsu in on loan at the moment. Actually, that's pretty good. I'm happy with that. I don't really know much about Newcastle this season. I know they're doing fairly well. I think they're second in the league right now as of making this, which is the 28th of December. Yeah, 28th. So we've got Tim Krul's out on loan. That's not great. I like Krul. He's a good manager. And good manager, good goalkeeper. Okay. That's fine. Revere, Tamalan is out on loan at the moment, but he's got a clause where, yeah. Okay, so he has to join. That's fine. Yeah, great. Responsibilities to recruit staff. It's going to change these, right? So generally, currently, I don't think we have a director of football. Let me check. No. So what I will generally do at some point is I'll hire a director of football. And then I'll have them deal with all of this. So they'll hire and fire all of the staff. And they'll generally deal with, you know, scouting and some contract renewals for the staff as well. Just because it's not something I want to be doing, to be honest with you. It's easier for me to get somebody else to do all of that. They'll generally get in the best that they can in all of this. Training at the moment is looking all right. We could do with some help on shooting, but it's not an immediate thing that we need to be looking at. When it comes to training though, we want to go to team, right? So generally I like to play, okay, wait, this is, what do I normally do here? I think I normally keep this balanced and average, and I get this on attacking movements. Don't worry about tactics right now. I think I have that unbalanced. In preseason I do sometimes change it to fitness and very high, but for now I'm going to leave it like that. I'm not going to worry about it too much, and hopefully that will work. We've got some introductory advice. So they want us to make Jack Colback the captain. Who's the current captain? Jamal Lascelles. Is that what I'm going to change it? Oh, yeah. I don't want to change the captain as soon as I come in. I'm happy with Lascelles at the moment. Use youth facilities, great, okay. Penalty takers, yeah, let's do that. Actually, let's just apply all of them, why not? Free kick takers, okay. That's not what I wanted to do. Can I just, I have to literally go to it and then apply it. That's fine, attackers to scout. So generally just, I generally just scout these. Julian Green, is that the, yeah, the Bayern winger slash striker, okay. If I can afford him, I'll be impressed. Apply. Okay, next thing I do, just check how much we got. Okay, we haven't got much to work with, but this is where this comes important. So it's all a little bit new to me. This is literally the first time I'm playing Football Manager 17 right now. So I don't know what's changed, what's new, what's old. I'm also playing on a bigger screen than usual. The new PC is a little bit quicker. So hopefully it's going to be quite a nice experience for me. I don't know what it works, but generally the formation I play with is this. Let's have a little bit of a look first through our players. We got individual tactical familiarity this year, which is great. I like that in introduction. Jose Perez is a cam. We're definitely going to want to utilize him. I think he's going to be one of the key players in this team. On top of that, we don't really have that many strikers. We've got Mitrovic, Gale. Is Daryl Murphy a striker? Yes, he is. So we've got Daryl Murphy, who I've not heard of, to be honest with you. And that's it. So we've got three strikers, which is kind of perfect for this formation, for a one-up-front formation. So let's just start building this team and see how it goes. So we're going to put... So it's easier to go through this way, so you can tell who your best is. Okay, we're going to go with Carl Darlow, just because, why not? Now we can go with Jesus Gámez or DeAndre Yedlin. Does Yedlin have... So Yedlin's got the potential to be very good. Gámez, at the moment, is 31. Let's get Yedlin in, because I know he's quick. If we get him in attacking like this, I think he could be... we can really utilise him there. On on the left-hand side. So we're going to get Mbemba and Lascelles. I'm actually going to swap these for no particular reason other than I like the idea of Lascelles as my right centre-back. Is he right-footed? I can't remember what it says. Yes, he's right-footed, okay. Mbemba, I'm pretty sure he's right-footed as well, but it's fine. Okay, so we got Mbemba. Not ideal. What about Lascelles? No, not ideal. Normally I'd like to have one ball-playing centre-back, and then I'll have like one central defender who's like a stopper or a cover. Or I'd like to have a ball-playing defender who's a stopper and then a central defender who's covering. But it's not the end of the world. Left-back. This guy's okay. I've got a feeling he might not be an actual left-back. Where is he? No, he's more of a left winger, okay. So we might have a problem with like wingers this far forward. So we'll see in a moment, but right, next up we've got a central midfield. For me, Chetiose just has to go in. Okay, we're gonna play him as a ball winning. Oh, is he a defensive midfielder? Oh, okay, he is. That's fine. I'm going to play Chetio as a central midfielder there, and we're going to have possibly John Joe Shelby, I think. Yeah, we're going to go John Joe Shelby, and we're going to make him an advanced playmaker. I like to have somebody in the midfield who will kind of contribute to what happens up here, and then hopefully Teote will kind of sit back and disrupt the play a little bit. Now, when it comes to our wingers, what have we got? Okay, we've got Matt Ritchie, who could play as an inside forward there. We have Atsu, who can play as a winger that side. That's perfect. So I like to have one inside forward, one winger. Got somebody who can like put them in, and somebody who'll get in to help out here. I already know that I want Mitrovic up here. I'm going to play him as a target man, and hopefully he's going to... Do I want him as a target man? That is his style of play, but... or do I want Gale up front? Maybe I do. So this is the first roadblock I've come against. We know that we want Jose Perez here, and we're going to have him as an advanced playmaker too. Dwight Gale. I think we're going to go with Dwight Gale. And then Mitrovic can be our backup. That's going to be the idea, I think. We're going to go with... Yeah, that's what we're going to go with. So we're going to put him there. So then the next thing I do is basically I set everything up to like, I have like a second 11 to make sure I have backup for every position. So with two centre backs, I don't think we have another left back, although he can play there. Gámez, he's our right back, isn't he? Yeah, so we have a backup right back. That's great. So defence is already sorted. They've got Anita. And I'm going to say callback. I think that's what I want to go with. Maybe Diame. I think we're going to try and sell. How old is callback? 26. Anita, 27. Yeah. So we're going to try and sell Diame. Because you need to do that to kind of create more. And then Gufran looks like he's a left winger in this game. I'm hoping you guys can't hear the background noise right now because I live in a student area and there are people going fucking nuts. Joys of living in a student area. So we're going to put him there. Mitro can go there. Alright, so Daryl Murphy. He's 33, he needs to go. Diame. 29. I think I'm going to get rid of him. We've got Isaac Hayden, who's another central midfielder who can help out. But we need a right winger and a central attacking mid. Next thing I always try to do is check in here because generally there'll be someone that's missed out, or Ronaldo Aarons. There we go. See? So we've got Rolando Arons, who can play... there used to be a way of... No. There used to be... So, hang on. Reports? Yeah. Right, so we got Rob Elliott. Okay, that doesn't matter. How long is he out for, actually? 3 months. Hadara. We might as well promote him for now. So, obviously, you've then got to look at who the potential players are. We've got Mbabu. And we've got Adu Pepra. Those players I've never heard of. Under 18s, nobody with potential there, which is a shame. So that's one of the things we'll work on. Hopefully we'll get that changed, because that's one of the most important things, I think, in Football Manager when you're looking at like a long-term goal, is you definitely need to have players that can play, that can come into the squad. So that's going to be an aim of this. And as for like how long I'll play this, I'll probably just continue playing it. Until people get bored or I get bored. Generally, I'll continue playing for quite a long time, to be honest with you. I don't know how long this is so far. I'm hoping not too long. So let's see. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to try and find a central attacking midfielder. So position, AMC. Interesting. Okay, so but Joshua Onoma, who I've heard of, I know of him. I think he's actually only just signed for. Where's he gone? No, he hasn't. Okay, he's been there for a while. So we've got Joshua Onoma, who's probably got quite a lot of potential. We'll get Maxim. Who else have I heard of? I've heard of this kid. Birkir Ozkan. I didn't actually check what I'd put my date of birth on this, you know. Bashilia, I know of. If we can get any of these on loan, that'll be, you know, that's ideal. Donis Abdiaye, in the previous few Football Managers has been, I guess, for 4 months, we're not going to be signing him. Has been a player that can turn into somebody who's incredible. Brannigan. Mateus Pereira. He, in previous Football Managers, turns into a great player also. Dali Sinkgraven. Lucas Evangelista. So these are all players that, if you've played Football Manager for quite a while, you're going to know about. They'll either have been stars in your games, or you know, you've probably signed them and they've done amazing things for you. But where it gets more interesting in this game is when you kind of get past the first 5 years, because that's when things get a little bit different and it gets fun. That's what I think personally. The first 5 years, they're great and you know they're fun, but normally, if I'm being very honest, I normally don't win much in the first 5 years. Hopefully we'll be able to change it for this. The scout is a Dan's son. Why not? Hopefully, I'll be able to. You know, we'll be able to do something in this. Win at least win the championship. I'm hoping we get promoted. If we don't, that'll be a huge disappointment. But yeah, generally, okay, interesting. I don't win much in the first 5 years, and then I, you know, win everything. Not quite that way, but you know, that's kind of how it happens. I think my best save, I took Everton to the best team in the world and became the best manager ever and all that kind of stuff. So that's what I'm hoping on doing in this save, but obviously with Newcastle. Hopefully we'll be able to stay with Newcastle throughout. So we've got... Okay, if we go to schedule. So I like to make sure that my team only plays maybe one game a week in the preseason. I don't want to overwhelm them. I can't cancel. Why can't I cancel that? Wait, can I not? Is it because I don't... It might be because I don't deal with friendlies. I can't cancel them. But our first game is going to be against Fulham. I'm pretty confident we can beat, to be honest with you. Speaking of Fulham, this kid used to turn into a bit of a star also. But yeah, so that's going to be where I come back to you when the preseason is done. We'll kind of have a look at what's happened and we'll get into the first game of the season. Okay, guys, I very quickly wanted to come back. Apparently your buys. Just to go through this with you. So obviously, the board has expectations for what they want us to do through the season. They want us to get promotion by winning the league. That's the that's not changeable. And they also want us to get to the fifth round, and to get to the FA Cup and get to the fourth round in the EFL Cup. Now, obviously, if I change these, it will adjust my wage budget and it will adjust my transfer budget. However, we're going to keep them at the lowest. I tend to do that for a few seasons because I don't want to go over the top. So that's the hope. You may also have noticed here that apparently Paris Saint-Germain want to sign Ayoze Perez. I'm hoping I'm going to be able to keep hold of him. But if they do want him, I'm going to ask for a fair chunk of money. I think we're going to ask for possibly 30 million because I can't let a player that, you know, that's key to our team go for cheap. So that's going to be the hopes. Is that hopefully if they do buy him, they spend a lot of money. But ideally, they're not going to. But that's all. I just wanted to quickly come back to you and go through that with you. Thanks, guys. And I'll be back with you in a moment to start the season off and kind of go through what we've done so far. And we're back, guys. Right, so we've made a few little changes, nothing huge. The main thing that we've changed is that we've brought in Bashilia. Again, for anybody who's played Football Manager in the past, you will know that Bashilia can turn into a superstar. Looks to be no different in this game. The kid looks very, very good in real life as well. So yeah, we managed to get him on a loan. Nothing permanent yet, and that's absolutely fine. We didn't want to spend any money if we could avoid it. And we've managed to avoid it. So we brought in Bashilia as backup to Ayoze Perez. I did look for a white winger, but honestly, there's nothing there out there that I think fits into this squad. So not great. We did try to get rid of Mohamed Diame. That just didn't happen. And we just thought we'd leave Daryl Murphy. I've also brought I've sent out a few players on loan, so we'll go through everything here. If I go into history, these players have gone out on loan. Again, nobody remarkable, to be honest with you. Now, if we go into... Where is it? It was somewhere. Is it in transfers? No. It's, if we find it, we'll be able to have a look at what transfers have gone on around the world. Is it maybe in the air? No. This is annoying. I've also had a little look at our finances. We have about 100 million in the bank, so we're okay at the moment. We are in the championship this season, so not ideal, but hopefully we'll be able to bring in enough money to kind of offset all of that. Here it is. So if we go into news, you can see that Aston Villa have signed Osman. We have a few deals that have gone on. Again, I don't think anything remarkable has really happened. The Emilio Insue has signed for Hoffenheim, but nothing in our league, nothing to really worry about. The only thing that we do have to worry about is obviously our first game of the season. Now, in the preseason, I think if I customize, here we go. So, in our first game, we beat NAC 4-1, which was great. Dwight Gayle got on the score sheet, as did Atsu and Hayden, and we had an own goal there as well. Dwight Gayle scored again in the second game, and in fact, I think Dwight Gayle scored in all of our friendly matches, which is a good sign. In the final game, we actually lost 3-1, and then we lost to Den Haag 4-3. In this game, Dwight Gayle, Mitrovic, and Tioke. I think this one, was it this one, where we Might not have been, no. Den Haag, we were kind of outplayed. I think it was final, in fact. Yeah, so the final game, we really didn't play badly. We just didn't convert our chances. We were the overall the better of the two teams, but we didn't convert our chances. So we then played Willem. I don't know how it's pronounced, really. Feel free to correct me on it. Christian Atsu scored a hat-trick. Again, Dwight Gale got on the score sheet. Jose Perez scored as well. Volendam, we beat with Mbemba, Retchie, and Gale again getting on the score sheet. And then we played Gateshead, which is our last match before the regular season. I'm quite happy that was quite an easy game. We've got Atsu, Gale, Perez, and Aarons on the score sheet. So now, we need to pick our team. I hate it when I do that. Oh, I just fucked everything up. Okay, so we need to pick our team. And that's up. So this is going to be our first team, realistically. This is what we're going to start with and what we're going to stick with for a little while. The only other change we've made is we put Grant Hanley in here instead of Mbemba. So what we're going to do here is we're going to chuck James. I generally don't go with a goalkeeper as a substitute because I just generally don't think you'll need it. I prefer to kind of roll the dice a little bit. So we'll get Mbemba, we'll get Bashilia. We'll get Aarons because he can play both sides. Now, Mitrovic is out for this game, so we're going to get Murphy in there. We'll also make sure I didn't want Hayden in, I wanted to call back. And I think we'll go Goofran as well. So that's going to be our team for the opening game here. I'm not sure what this dark bar means. I don't know if that's like how they can be with it. But anyway, the other thing that I changed is I put us onto an attacking mentality. And I changed our instructions slightly. So I've made our tempo a lot lower. So this is the what I generally tend to do on Football Manager. I made our tempo a lot lower. And I made stay on feet but close down a lot more. And then I leave this and put retain possession on. The reason I do that is because I want us to keep the ball as much as possible, move it well. And obviously I want us to win the ball back as quickly as possible as well. So that's going to be the team, I think, going into the first game. I'm happy with it. The only change I could make is probably put Gamas in instead of Yedlin, but I'm hoping Yedlin will progress through the season. But yeah, let's kind of get underway. There are a few changes we're going to need to make here as we get into the game, because I haven't yet loaded this game up or changed any of the settings, so you might hear some annoying noise right about in a moment when it loads. Generally, it doesn't take this long, but it's because it's the first time I've loaded it. Right, so I was put this on key, and we always have this on 2D Classic. I like to play in 2D Classic. If you guys want me to play 3D, let me know and I'll switch it to one of these, but generally this is what I do. I move that, I'm between the highlights all the way up. I'm going to move that slightly, we'll have it there. For now, we want sounds off and we want no replays. Okay, so we'll go with that. Now, in the opposition instructions, oh great, okay. Well, we need a new assistant then. There we go. So we're going to get Antonio Gomez to do it. And then we're going to do this with a favorite here to go out and give a fan's performance here for. So this is what I always tend to do, is my team talks always this way, pretty much. I might change it down now and then. I'll generally go with whatever the assistant says here, and then I'll make sure I put you have faith, passionate, and that can boost morale a little bit. So we're going to start this off, and let's see how we get on. We're playing against Fulham in our first match. And hopefully, we win. This is new. I'm not sure I like this, to be honest. The stats, I don't know if you could... I'm not sure I'm a fan of that. Hopefully, we don't lose this game. This is not good. Oh, Kearney scored his fucking... Fuck. Kearney scored against us early on there. That's not a good start. Dwight Gale's lost it again. Kearney's got the ball, and thankfully, Lascelles has won that there. Tiote, Shelby, out to Atsu. Atsu's done well here to get past this man. It's cleared. So I don't know how the engine plays this year. I've not really... Go on, Dale. Oh, Gale. Not Dale. I'm not sure how the engine plays this year because I've not really, like I say, I've not really played it. I've not watched any videos or any streams or anything like that around this game. Because to be honest, I was very much of the mind that I was going to keep playing Football Manager 16. But one of my friends, who may indeed watch this video, Reese, kind of, you know, nagged me to get the game a little bit, and I gave in. So it does look good. He did show me a few things. So I'm hoping it's an improvement on last year, but we'll see. Right, so Yedlin, Shelby, Perez. Go on. Go on, Atsu. What a beautifully worked fucking goal that was. Christian Atsu puts it away off of Matt Ritchie. Bit of a scrub pass, really, across goal. But still, that gives us the equaliser. I'm far from pleased. I want to see more than that. Now, the only thing that I have also noticed that I generally try to avoid doing is that my date of birth is actually my birthday on this. It's actually younger than my birthday, come to think of it. No, we're kind of in the past on this. So I'm actually 22 on this game, which isn't ideal. I generally like to be in my 30s, so kind of it's easier to you know, for the players to have a little bit of respect for you, I guess. But that's not been the case. Right, so I was about to say I want to bring on Mitrovic, but he's not actually available. And Murphy, yeah, we're going to try it. We're going to try and bring us into the game a little bit more by bringing on Murphy. I don't think we need to make any other changes just yet. I think we're doing okay, to be honest with you. So let's see how this goes. Obviously, these games go quite quickly. Oh, no. Oh, no. Fucking hell. That's literally come off like three different men there. We're going to change that to overload there. I might have to change this to control. All right, let's see. Lascelles, Yedlin, Tiote, Shelby, Ayoze. Come on, come on. Come on, Atsu. Shelby again. Tiote. Give. Oh, that's decent. That's decent. Anyone? Atsu! Sounds like I'm sneezing. But he's got us our second game of the goal of the game. Atsu looks like a fantastic signing already, to be honest with you. And I can't even take credit for him. Oh, well, Tiote, oh, he's lost it. Don't do that. Oh, Lascelles, come on, you need to keep up. Thank God for that. One thing we don't want to do is lose our first game of the season. An away game, I can take a draw. It's not the worst thing in the world. But it's not ideal, obviously. But, yeah, Murphy holds the ball. That's not what we need. That is, thankfully, he's put it wide. But that was shocking. That was absolutely shocking from Murphy. Seems to control the ball. I just kind of knock it to nobody. Right, so we've drawn the first game. 2-2 away from home. It isn't ideal. And I'm gonna tell the team that. I'm going to let them know it's not ideal. Christian Atsu, though, what a fantastic performance from him. He covered a lot of ground as well. I'm very, very pleased with that. Paul Dummett as well, covering a lot of ground. And Yedlin. So I'm very happy with the team's like performance. They have covered a lot of ground, so I'm pretty happy with that, to be honest. Dwight Gill, not the start to the season that I was hoping for, but Atsu has been very, very good. So hopefully he can continue that form as well. Overall, honestly, to be honest, we that's not what I meant to do. How do I get back from this? I'll take me to the home page. I don't want to be on an analysis page. So I just... What do I do? Up here? No, maybe I do just click that one. That's not what I clicked, but... okay, so there you go. It's up here. Oh, it's being blind. But yeah, Atsu scored twice. To be honest, overall, we're probably the better team. Nothing huge in it, though, to be honest. Fulham had their fair share of chances. We drew the opening game of the season. We came from behind twice. I can't really complain too much. The one thing I will say is I'm going to give it a little bit of time because at the moment the team's not completely familiar with the tactics, and hopefully they will become familiar and then we'll be kind of okay with it all. But yeah, definitely I think Atsu was our saving grace in that game. Yeah, it was a good goal. So there's interest in Tiote and Perez. So hopefully, so far we've managed to keep up with them both, but we'll see what happens. Sure was a fair result on the day, I think. Oh man, no. I need to see what can bring to the team. Okay, that's fine. So that is our first game of the season over and done with. So what we're going to do is we're going to have a quick look at the schedule and see where we're going to rejoin. So I think a good place to reconvene is going to be the Brighton game right here. So we'll have played our first EFL Cup game. We'll pretty much gotten through the entirety of August, and we'll kind of reconvene here. And I'll kind of give you a rundown of what's happened in August and so on. And then I think what we'll do is we'll probably do every month. We'll revisit and see what's going on. If there are any games that you guys want to watch specifically, let me know and I can make sure that we get those videos uploaded. Thank you very much for watching, guys. That is going to be the end of this video. Please do like, comment and subscribe. They really do help with growing the channel. And obviously just give me any suggestions on the format, anything that you think is wrong, any constructive criticism, I do very much appreciate. Thanks for watching, guys.